Hey there folks, Andrew here at Chatfuel. You can see that today I am in front of the camera rather than behind it like I normally am. Wanted to switch things up a little bit, but today's video is all about the 7 most powerful tools you can use in Chatfuel for e-commerce for your business. So stick around, we'll dive in. This is just a quick and dirty, simple guide to basically give you the maximum value possible out of Chatfuel. Also, one more thing before we do dive in, if you don't mind, below this video, give it a thumbs up. Really helps us out with the YouTube algorithm and sharing this valuable information with more people like yourself. So that being said, let's jump in. Number 1 is using the user phone and user email quick replies plugin in Chatfuel. And by the way, for each of these tips, I'm just going to talk about them. In the description, I will have linked tutorials, other videos I've already created about these that go into more extensive detail. This is just to give a broader explanation of these 7 tools. But anyway, what these quick replies do is pre-populate the user's contact information, either their email or their phone, whatever plugin you choose to use, whatever data is more valuable to you. You can also use both in conjunction, but basically these allow you to pre-populate that data. And obviously marketing is not just about doing marketing on Messenger, it's also about doing that omni-channel. So email and SMS marketing as well. These 2 plugins let you do exactly that, easily capture that data in a frictionless way. It just suggests that information to the user, they tap it, and with 1 click, you've got it captured. All right, next up, number 2, we have the Save to Google Sheets plugin. This is just a fancy way of saying export user data, essentially. The most valuable use case that I've found for it is for contests. So say that in your e-commerce store, you're running some sort of contest where you have people entering and you're gonna pick a winner to get, I don't know, a free year's supply of clothes, for example. What you can do is easily and automatically send those contest entrants, all their information, to one centralized location, a spreadsheet, a Google sheet, and then you have all that data there, so it's super easy to pick a winner. The alternative to this would be, you know, having to manually filter through and sort through all these messages in your Facebook inbox, potentially thousands, tens of thousands of messages, and that's really inconvenient. So the Google Sheets plugin saves you a ton of time, and all you need to do to set it up is log in with your Google account and select which fields you want to pass over. Number 3 is our newly released Cart Reminders plugin. This is a no-brainer if you run a Shopify store for e-commerce. As you might imagine, it's super easy to set up and extremely powerful. Basically, if somebody's signed into their Facebook account, when they go to your Shopify store, they add something to their cart but don't complete the purchase, you can then automatically retarget and remind them on Messenger, and they'll be more likely to convert, not only because you're sending that reminder, but also they're more likely to convert than they would if you send this through email. So the value proposition is super clear, and you can track all the revenue that you're recovering in the Chatfuel dashboard, so that value proposition and benefit is very concrete and understandable to you. Number 4, we are halfway there, folks. Number 4 is the comment acquisition tool in Chatfuel, also in the Grow tab, just like the cart reminders feature. This is really, really valuable and really a great way to drive organic traffic to your Messenger bots. So maybe you have a fairly low budget, you can't run click to Messenger ads. What you can do instead is experiment with comment acquisition. As you might imagine, this works by the user simply commenting on a post that you set up this comment acquisition tool on. Once they comment on that post, the bot will then send them a message and they will be counted as a subscriber once they engage with that message. So again, great way if you're already getting engagement on your Facebook fan pages to convert that traffic into Messenger bot subscribers. If you want to get even fancier, you can not only capture them as subscribers, but based on the comments that they leave on that post, such as if it's a women's fashion brand, if they comment heels or dresses, you can also then segment them as such in Messenger so that when you're doing future retargeting and promotions, you can reach a relevant audience. So it benefits the user by getting these promotions, and you benefit by capturing this additional customer data. Number 5 is, drumroll please, the A/B test plugin. This is a way to evenly distribute the traffic coming into your Chatfuel bot to different variations of content so that you can measure how people are reacting and responding, see which variation of content converts them best, and then double down your efforts on that to ultimately increase sales. So As a more concrete example, let's say that you have 1,000 people coming into your Chatfuel bot. What you can then do with this plugin is divide them into two or more groups of, let's say, 500 each, if we're dividing it into two groups. So 500 people see one variation, 500 see another. On that first variation, let's say it's a picture, a very nice close-up shot of the cookie dough ice cream that you sell. And on another, it's a wider shot showing that cookie dough ice cream in a pint container. So then with this A/B test plugin, you can say, okay, well, on this block with the wider shot, for whatever reason, it converted better. The click-through rate to my Shopify store was, let's say, 50% versus just 25% or some other number with the close-up shot. So we're going to double down. We're going to remove the A/B testing plugin and then just send all our traffic to the wider picture because clearly that's converting better, at least in terms of sending traffic to our website. So that's what the A/B test plugin is all about. Data matters, and this allows you to achieve your goals using informed decisions with data. Number six is the export users feature in the People tab. This is a far less apparent plugin or feature in Chatfuel, but if you're a pro user, definitely take advantage of it. Essentially, how this works is you can create a segment and filter out the most valuable people in your bot, whether those are people who have purchased from you, so customers, people who have provided their email, or maybe just people who have repeatedly come back to the bot using the sessions attribute, which allows you to quantify and measure how many people are repeatedly coming back. So whatever metric of success or value you're using, you can again filter out those users in the People tab, click export. It'll export a CSV file of those users in your bot. You can then upload that file to Facebook, and Facebook will create for you, in the form of Facebook ads, what are called lookalike audiences. And essentially, this is Facebook's way of extrapolating that existing customer data you have, not targeting those customers from that list, but extrapolating it to find you new customers who share the same valuable and desirable characteristics of those existing customers. So long story short, it's a way to combine Chatfuel and Facebook's intelligence to create and find you new customers who are just as valuable, if not more valuable, for a fraction of the cost. Last but not least, number seven is the Export via Zapier plugin. This is a real game changer when we added it. It allows you to integrate Chatfuel with thousands of other third-party apps and tools to make your workflow and chatbot experience all the more efficient. So for example, one way to use this is connecting Chatfuel to MailChimp. Let's say in your e-commerce store, you're running a promo where you say, hey, customer, give us your email, using something like the user email plugin, which I mentioned earlier, in exchange for a 20% off coupon. So what you could do then is as soon as you capture that user's email, using the Export via Zapier plugin, you can automatically export that information to your CRM like MailChimp and sync that in real time so that unlike some other person who's doing this on Facebook, you don't have to manually go in every time and sync and copy and paste that email to your CRM. Instead, it's done for you entirely on autopilot. You just set it and forget it, and you're good to go. So that is the Export via Zapier plugin. But again, it's not just limited to MailChimp. You can integrate with thousands and thousands of other tools as well. And that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. If you found any of these seven tools valuable in Chatfuel, please leave a thumbs up down below. Also down below, let me know which of these seven tools is your favorite, which one is most valuable to you, which do you like using the most. For me, by far, it's the cart reminders feature, just because one, it was recently added. Two, the value proposition is super clear. It shows you the impact this plugin is having in a very real way to your bottom line, to your revenue. And also number three, it's just ridiculously easy to set up in a couple clicks or less. So that's it for me. Again, leave a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching and happy botting. Number five is, I almost did like a Spock thing there where I like separated my fingers like that. The one piece of content you're using, a very close up, beautiful. They're just so excited about the ice cream, they can't contain themselves. And you want to split those between two different types of content to see which. What the hell is which? I know what which is, but not which.